Hello and welcome to another edition of CME Group's Trader's Edge. Today we're going to be considering central bank policy and its effects on FX rates. Not the U.S. central bank, even though the U.S. Fed is meeting this week to discuss its rate policy. We're going to be focusing our attention on two other central banks that will be meeting next week and the week after. And we're going to be considering those rates, those meetings and the possible resulting changes in rates and the impact it might have on the FX marketplace. To begin with, I'll start by mentioning that this is the important thing to consider with FX is that they trade in pairs. And sometimes the futures contracts do not trade in the same currency configurations as the spot market. The two currencies we're going to be considering today, the Mexican peso in the Indian rupee, trade in European terms in the spot market, but in the futures contracts trade in American terms, which means they're quoted in US dollar terms, and that has an impact both on the number that you see represented on your trading screens, but it also has to do with and will have an impact on how the futures contract prices versus the underlying spot. As you can see by this chart, short-term interest rates do have an impact on the forward and the futures price in terms of where that interest rate for that particular currency sits in the equation you see in the screen. In the futures contracts we're going to be considering, the terms currencies are both going to be US dollar. The base currencies will be the currency pair, the side of the currency pair that we refer to as we get in a little bit closer to that discussion. This is important not just in terms of being quoted in American or European terms, but will affect the pricing mechanism of the futures as it relates to the spot market. Because both of these economies, the Mexican peso and the Indian rupee, have short-term interest rates higher than the U.S. rate at the moment, their currencies trade at a discount due to positive carry. This will be important in terms of understanding the price differential between the futures and the spot as you consider them in the marketplace. Let's begin by considering the Mexican peso. Inflation has historically been an issue in emerging and developing economies, and central banks like the Central Bank of Mexico, also known as Banxico, are tasked with helping those economies deal with and controlling rampant inflation through monetary policy. Most of last year, in 2008, the Central Bank of Mexico was raising its rates along with what was going on here in the United States with our Fed raising rates. But beginning with around the turn of the year, going into the new calendar year of 2019, that situation began to change. Recent economic data in Mexico suggests that both growth and inflation have been falling. And due to the fact that our own central bank, the Fed here in the US, has appeared to shift to maybe a less hawkish stance, at least for the first half of this year, that's going to reduce pressure on the Bank of Mexico to defend the peso via its monetary policy committee rate. Those couple of factors together going into next week's March 28th monetary policy committee meeting may give the Central Bank of Mexico room to lower its base rate from 7.5% to some other figure that could be lower. That could have an impact on the way the currency trades both in the spot market as well as in the forward markets. CME Group has futures contracts that are actively traded in the Mexican peso and also has a very growing and developing options on peso futures market as well. If you've got any questions about those, you can consult our website and or consult your FCM for request for quotes. This chart shows you the peso to the dollar in peso terms, and you can see that the trading band has narrowed considerably over the last several weeks, trading down into the resistance level at or just below 19 pesos to the dollar. In US dollar terms, which is the terms in which the currency futures are traded, the currency has also rallied nicely over the last several weeks and is up near the higher end of its most recent trading band. As you can see on that little hook on the far right of the chart. Now let's consider the Indian rupee. Like the Mexican economy, inflation has historically been a problem in the emerging markets of Asia, and the Central Bank of India, the Reserve Bank of India, is also tasked with helping to contain inflation through its monetary policy. India's demographics and growth numbers are very impressive. The economy currently growing at a 7 to 7.5% rate, but like what we saw in Mexico, recent economic indicators, particularly toward the end of the year and going into the first part of this year, suggest that both the economy is slowing and the rate of inflation, consumer inflation, has dropped considerably. Retail consumer inflation has fallen below 4%, which is below the Reserve Bank of India's medium target inflation range, suggesting that they've got some room to possibly ease up on their short-term rates. This can be a double-edged sword for policymakers because low inflation, which is good for consumers who are also voters, isn't necessarily in the best interest of farmers or people producing the agricultural products, which also represent a large segment of the economic workforce. Their central policy meeting will be on April 4th, and they also have a nationwide general election the following week. So both of these things and a rate change could be significantly important, not just for the currency, but also for domestic policy. Recent drops in U.S. Treasury yields have also given an initial strength to the currency pair in favor of the rupee. The fact that that's moved to the higher end of the trading band, as represented here by the currency pair quoted in rupee terms, below 70 rupee per the dollar. And then you can see it trading above its most recent range in U.S. dollar terms, which is the terms in which the futures contract trades. In conclusion, for risk managers and traders who are looking to trade foreign exchange markets or have exposure to either of these currencies, CME has liquid futures contracts in both. Highly recommend you consider this as we go into the next 2 weeks when the central bank policy committees meet, as their result on interest rate policy could have an effect on the currencies both in spot and in futures terms. I hope you found this segment useful. If you've got any questions about any CME products or any of our marketplace activities, I would steer your attention to CME Institute, which can be linked via our website. There's lots of educational videos and webinars available there for you to view at your leisure. And as always, as you consider market and trading activities, remember to always do your homework. Thank you and good luck.